I'm filled with a great sense of gratitude, happiness, and purpose as I stand here today. But more than anything, a great responsibility to deliver a message, a dream that I held in my heart since childhood. I'm not going to speak to you today about something new or unheard of. Yet, at the same time, it has the ability, the energy, and the power to change and to transform this world. The power of kindness. The magic of kindness. The magic of people. Some people call me a dreamer, but I mean, aren't we all dreamers? But even dreams need to be put into action. I became a middle school teacher because I wanted to make a difference in the lives of my students at a time when it mattered most, when their self-value and their self-worth was being challenged every day. I just wanted to help them open their eyes to see the beauty in the world, the beauty in others, and more importantly, the beauty in themselves. To help them recognize that who they are, what they do, matters. So I started a project. Acts of kindness cards. Each card with a different act of kindness, with really simple instructions. Perform the act and pass the card to someone else to keep the kindness going. Why cards? Because kindness as a term could sometimes be so broad, and I wanted to be able to bring it down to their level, make it more specific, show them that it could be something as small as opening the door for someone or inviting someone to sit at lunch with you, to show them that one act can have a profound impact and help them see all of the amazing opportunities that are there all the time. So what happened? I mean, their self-value increased tremendously. They started feeling powerful, and they started getting excited about different acts of kindness that they would see. They began to see the ripple effect of kindness, and that kindness is infectious. And to them, that was the coolest thing ever. But the truth is, I didn't realize the potential of these cards until one day I was coming home from school and it was really hot, and there were these community service workers on the street. So I ran to my house and I got a bunch of drinks and I brought it out to them. They were so grateful, so shocked, but they were so grateful. And I happened to go into my pocket, and I had in my pocket 8 acts of kindness cards. And right there, 8 community service workers. And so I gave each and every one of them a card. And one of the guys approached me with tears in his eyes, and he grabbed onto his card, and he started screaming, "How did you know to give me this card? How did you know to give me this card?" For the past couple weeks, I've been thinking about calling my parents. It's been 10 years since I've spoken to them, and on my card it says, "Call your mother and father to tell them how much you love them." That was it. That was all he needed, a reminder, a push in the right direction, something to show him that, you know, this is kindness. And we start doing kindness and looking for it, we start seeing opportunities everywhere. One day I was leaving Madison Square Garden, and there was a man sitting in a wheelchair with a cup in one hand and a sign in the other. But what stood out most were his eyes. I mean, he was looking frantically back and forth with somebody, somebody to connect with, anybody to connect with. So I saw a hot dog stand, and I went over, I got a hot dog and a bottle of water, and I came over to him. His name was Hutch. And he said to me, "You got this for me?" And I said, "Of course." At that moment, we connected. And he looked at me, and he said, "You see me." And he called me his angel. That's the feeling of kindness. Little did he know that he was my angel. But I wanted to be able to help people see what I was seeing and feel what I was feeling, but kindness is really hard to articulate in words. So I created a film, which you're gonna see a little piece of. I didn't write a script, I just told the story of the world I live in. The world I saw, small acts that left an imprint on my heart. But it's not just the world that I live in, the truth is it's the world we all live in. Sometimes we just need to open our eyes and change of perspective.
Sometimes I live under the moon. I thank God I'm breathing. And I pray, don't take me soon, 'cause I am here for a reason. Sometimes in my tears I drown, but I never let it get me down. So when negativity surrounds, I know someday it'll all turn around, because
one act of kindness can go on, and sometimes like a boomerang, come back to us at a time when we need it the most. When I put this film up, I figured maybe it'll, you know, a few people will stumble upon it. Little did I know that over 20 million people would be inspired. I want to tell you a story about a young boy, a student of mine, who was labeled by everyone as a bully. And that's exactly what he became. But he was so much more than that. There was this one incident where he got into trouble, and it was kind of the last straw. They were talking about kicking him out. They already wrote him off. And I went over and I stood up for him. I'll never, ever forget the look on his face. No one had ever done that for him before. And he came over to me with tears in his eyes, and he said, "I don't understand. Why do you care? I'm so mean to you." And I looked at him and I said, "Because I think the world of you. And I only hope that one day you could see yourself through my eyes." And that was it. Kindness. That boy's now in college, and he mentors troubled youth. And he said to me, "You bet on me when no one else did. Everyone deserves to have somebody to bet on them." That's kindness. I mean, it's inspiring, but, you know, inspiration fades. So the question is, how do we sustain it? How do we take inspiration and turn into action and back into inspiration again? So I started an organization that does just that. I'm working on a mobile app, a social network for kindness that allows people to set their own personal kindness goals and see their progress, be able to connect with others. And more than that, actually be able to track their acts of kindness as they go from one person to the next. Show their real impact on the world. Only thing now is I guess I got to learn how to code. You know, the idea of it is to make kindness trending. Because kindness is so naturally contagious, so I figured, why not make it viral? You know, during this week, we've been talking about innovations and ideas that can change the world. And there are so many different ways to change the world. Some may take millions of dollars, and some may take complex strategies. But what's so cool about kindness, what makes it so amazing, is that it's accessible to everyone. One act of kindness can have unknown and profound consequences. It's the extraordinary effects of ordinary acts of kindness that can, in fact, change this world. Thank you. Thank you.